I'm Sherry, this is iDS Magazine Asia. Welcome to our channel. And today we have a special guest, Mr. Nathan Wither, the CEO of Network Optix, who came all the way from the United States. And welcome to Taiwan, Mr. Wither.
Thank you.
Would you please say hi to our audience, to the camera, and tell us about yourself?
Hello, everyone. I'm Nathan Wither. I'm the founder and CEO of Network Optix. Happy to be back in one of my favorite cities, Taipei.
Thank you, and welcome to Taiwan again. And now we are at the Expo of Securtech now, and we all know about that Network Optix has been rapidly expanding in the global security market in recent years, and your unique open platform has also been well received by all the partners and end users alike. And now I've heard that you've been chosen Taiwan to open the APAC headquarter office, and that is awesome and thrilling news to Taiwan. Thank you to choose us. And why did you choose Taiwan?
Taiwan is one of the centers of the technological innovation of the world, frankly. It is hardware, software, most of the driving technology behind all things that are happening in our industry right now, or in pretty much any industry that's being touched by visual technology or computer vision technology, plus a great talent pool of good people. Setting up an office here gives us reach to the rest of the Asia Pacific market, gives us access to a lot of really good talented people, and access to an amazing partner array of hardware and software vendors that we've partnered with to great success over time, as we are here with many of the Taiwanese-based software companies that use our platform. Our office has an amazing view as well over Da'an Park and the National Transportation or the National Train Station there. So there's that too.
Wow, that's very good. I'm curious about something. In your observation, is there any difference between Asia application and other area, and what are the differences?
Security itself and security technology are largely being overtaken by the larger industry of computer vision, gathering intelligence from the video that you're watching. Essentially AI watching our TV for us, watching our video for us. Every region has its own different implementation of that, its own enforcement policies, its own use case for business automation, for gathering more business and actionable intelligence. Asia's are specifically Taiwan and the Asia Pacific region, tend to be very focused around people, wanting to know what your customers are doing, what your students are doing in a school, what your employees are doing at their work site, as well as a lot of infrastructure related, what the construction sites are doing, what the freeway traffic is doing, what the optimal road situations are doing. So it's some of the more advanced use cases of it, but it is very much similar use cases to the rest of the world, just with regional differences and with, frankly, better regional technology partners in the region to be able to execute quickly and deliver those types of intelligent solutions.
As we all know, Network Optix is always doing very great on integration of video management and new features, and NX Witness have launched version 5.1 already. So can you tell us more about it?
Certainly. So NX Witness is Network Optix flagship video surveillance and security product. It's unique and specialized specifically for the security industry. Our larger platform accommodates the much larger computer vision and visual intelligence industry. Most of what came out in 5.1 or as what is part of our fifth generation evolution of our software is leading towards that larger computer vision. So there are new features, cross-system viewing so that you can monitor multiple systems simultaneously, monitor multiple sites, multiple locations of your business, your facility, your organization, all at the same time. The features tend to be features that are coming out of our larger platform and the larger demand for more enterprise. People want to connect more and more and more cameras to the same intelligent system. it's a much different proposition to have 100,000 cameras connected to the same system gathering intelligence than it is to have 100 cameras connected to the same system. In a security scenario, you tend to have a much less camera count, just a few cameras per facility or a couple dozen cameras per facility. But if you have then thousands of facilities and you want to aggregate the information across all of them, that takes a much larger enterprise and infrastructure component. And it's frankly the core of where we're going with everything. Being able to scale the product that's been so beloved for so long up into an infinite scale so it can be used to run an entire country's infrastructure, an entire country's freeway system and intelligence gathering system, or a large retail chain with 10,000 facilities gathering all their customer information for them. Feature by feature, it's got a bunch of new stuff as every new release of our security product does, but most of it is all moving towards a larger enterprise scale and to this larger objective that everybody's trying to achieve from getting more actionable intelligence out of their video.
Okay, so now we are all very curious about what is the next step of Network Optix and what can we expect to see in the future?
Sure, that's a big question, but a good one. Like I said, everything for us is leading towards the much larger computer vision industry. Every day you find people are finding new ways to gather information out of their video feeds, how their crops are growing, what pests are bothering their crop. Every industry, agricultural, transportation, retail, education, every one of them has needs for more intelligence and for connecting more and more cameras to the same intelligence gathering system as a unified enterprise. Everything we're doing is following that trend. How do we make it more distributed, whether it's containerizing it and dockerizing it, whether it's offering our cloud as a private cloud that anyone can run behind their own enterprise, whether it's opening more and more capabilities for our independent, our ISV partners, the companies here in Taiwan and through Greater Asia that are writing really amazing software that gathers more and more information out of video, giving them a platform that allows them to take this great idea and this great intelligence and have a go-to-market solution ready to go that they can become a global powerhouse in their space. Whether it's gathering freeway information for optimizing transportation, or whether it's gathering your customer information of where they're going in your retail stores, or what their buying patterns are based on the demographics of your customers. People want to know more. They want to know more what their customers are doing, what their organizations are doing, what their freeways are doing, and giving them a platform that's more open, that's more scalable, that's lighter weight, so it goes on even smaller chips, can live on board your camera, can live inside your own behind your own firewall, inside your own data centers. It's our primary directive.
Wow, this sounds pretty great.
We love it.
Okay, then next question will be about a very hottest topic right now in Taiwan that we all have been talking about, ChatGPT for these days. And we are curious about if you are going to try to integrate similar technologies in future.
Certainly. GPT is obviously, it's shown the world what the potential is. ChatGPT and what it can do with natural language processing and interactive communications directly with it changed our perspective of what's possible. But ultimately, ChatGPT is language specific. So it would be wonderful for somebody to be able to just talk to our solution, talk to our platform and say, I want to know the following. Separate the information for me that is all of my customers by this type, by this gender, by this class, or between these times and at these regions and within these stores, and tell me their buying trends, and have a GPT come back and give you all of that information sorted from where it all exists in your computer vision. But honestly, I actually see the next step of it, which using GPT for scene contextualization, being able to pre-train models so that the computer vision that's watching your video can sit there and say, this is a person walking across the sidewalk when the light is red or when the light is green, and literally just generate that details for you as part of your notification, as part of your alert. This is what's happening. A car on a wanted list or a license plate that is being watched for, or a face of an employee has been recognized after hours, and being able to actually tell you that just as a message on your phone, or have it show up as a notification on your system. And it's not an operator that's telling you that. It's not a security guard that's watching your cameras at night saying, hey, there's some stranger that jumped our fence. It's your system telling you that, hey, there's a person we don't recognize jumping over the fence and they're currently walking towards the main building. There's nothing that says a computer can't do that. So that's the type of stuff we're planning on integrating. We're actually working with some of it right now, but ultimately that's where I'd like to go with it.
Thank you for your time and thank you for accepting our interview. And we have learned about many, many different ideas from you today. And this is awesome to me. I wish all the audience in front of the screen can feel the same. So now let's say bye to them. Say bye to the camera.
It's been my pleasure, Sherry. Thank you.
Thank
bye
you.
Bye, everybody.
Thank you. Bye. We'll be right back.